When you're new to machine learning, you will hear this term features a lot. Features, features engineering, things like that. And you might wonder what exactly is features in terms of machine learning. I'm going to give you a very simple layman explanation. No mathematics involved. Let's say you are doing a property price prediction problem. This is one of the classical problems in machine learning. Here, you're trying to predict the price of a home using machine learning based on certain factors such as area, facilities, how old is the home, the location. Obviously, when you go to buy a home, these are some of the factors that you will use to determine the price of the home. And these factors are called features. These are the factors based on which the target variable, here it is price, is determined. Therefore, in this case, these are called features. Let's look at another problem. You're trying to classify images, dog versus cat. Let's think, as a human, you're walking on the road. You see dog or a cat coming near to you. How do you identify that it's a dog or a cat and not a lion? You do feature detection in your brain. You don't consciously realize, but in your brain, there are neurons. And these units try to detect different features. For example, nose. You look at the nose and you try to identify, is it a cat's nose or a dog's nose or a human nose? Similar with other things such as eyes. If you look at cat's eyes, they are round. Dog's eyes are a little different, as you can see in the diagram, especially ears. See here in this image, dogs have the ears which are kind of falling down, and cat will have pointed ears. So ears can also help you determine whether it's a cat or dog. So just think about this. I don't give you the whole picture. Let's say I give you just the ears. Based on ears also, sometimes, not all the time, you can have some clue what kind of animal this would be. Then cats have very prominent whiskers, you know, the things that come out of from between nose and her mouth. So based on these features, you can determine whether it's a cat or a dog. So obviously the features here are eyes, nose, whiskers, ears, and so on. And when you use neural network, again, I'm giving you a very simplistic explanation. If you're looking for detailed explanation, go to YouTube, search for Code Basics Convolutional Neural Network. I would have given a better detailed example, but this is more for a layman, you know, for your like top level understanding. You will have neurons, and neurons is just a unit which is doing a specific task. So let's say one neuron is working on if it's a cat's ears or not. Then there is another neuron which detects whether it's a nose or not, and so on. And if in the image you have cat's ears, nose, and eyes, it means you have cat's head. Similarly, if you have cat's legs and tail, it means you have cat's body, like the body below the head. And if you have answer for head and body as yes, then it means it's a cat. Think about a different image where I just put some portion of dog's image on top of cat's image. Let's say if I show you this image and ask you, is it a cat or not? You might not be able to answer correctly. Again, I have made up this example for your understanding. But if I have mixed things up, then what happens is my neural networks will say ears and nose. They will say no. If I ask whether this is for cat, the answer will be no. Hence, the answer for whether it's a cat's head or not will be no. So my overall answer, whether this is cat or not, might be no. All right, so we talked about property price prediction example, which is a general statistical machine learning problem. Anything related to images is mostly solved by something called convolutional neural network. So you're getting into the world of deep learning. And when it comes to text, let's say I have these three texts, okay? And I'm doing some natural language processing problem. And if I ask you to extract features, if I say, okay, what are the features of this text? Now that's a tricky question. How do you come up with the features of this text? And if you play cricket, you would know Dhoni and Cummins, they are the cricket players, and Australia, the word Australia is a country. So you see, the first two are players, the third one is a country. How do you represent these three words, which is Dhoni, Cummins and Australia as a feature vector, or how to extract features out of this. One of the ways you can try is you can come up with a set of factors such as personality, healthy, location, has two eyes, has government, and so on. If you look at Dhoni, he's a person, yes. He's healthy and fit, 0.9, yes. 1 means perfectly yes, 0.9 is yes. He's healthy and fit, I know, but maybe not as healthy, 0.9, right? So as close as to 1. Is it a location? Is Dhoni a location? No, he's a person, it's not a location. So 0. Does Dhoni have a government? Well, you might say yes, maybe his wife and his kids, but yeah, the answer is 0. But when you look at Australia as a country, they have government, they are a location. Does Australia have two eyes? No. So see, when you get all these numbers, 1.9010, this forms a feature vector. So these are the features of text. Now I use some random example again for your understanding, but there are sophisticated approaches available in the field of natural language processing, such as word embedding. And there are popular models such as BERT, which can extract these features using semi-supervised, or sometimes people call it unsupervised machine learning. I hope that gave you a basic understanding of what is features. If you have any question, post in a comment box below. Also visit my website codebasics.io for affordable courses. Right now I have just Python and data analysis in Power BI course. I'm planning to release more courses and bootcamp in the future.